We've all heard the throwback. Young people are bringing outdated styles back into popular culture. Well, it is now happening in China. Young people there have a new affinity for all things Mao. The communist leader was the founder of the People's Republic of China, but his so-called cultural revolution resulted in the deaths of millions of people. New York Times columnist Anand Giridharadas, he saw the trend firsthand in his recent trip to Beijing, and he reported on what he found in an article, how Mao became a hipster icon. Anand, great to see you. Great article. Very provocative here. Describe for me what you saw in China, this new alternative scene that seems to glorify Mao.
So it's interesting. When you at first walk down the grand boulevards of today's China, the first thing you see is the opposite, which is just senseless copying of Western consumption, Burberry shops, Rolls-Royce dealerships, Nike and Adidas everywhere. But I started to see on some of the hutongs, the old Chinese lanes that are perpendicular to those big boulevards, an equal and opposite trend, which is all these vintage shops that were selling the old Maoist past back to a young generation of Chinese who didn't frankly live during that period, don't know its horrors, and were kind of attracted to these vintage shoes and vintage watches and vintage skin cream even as a way of lashing out against the kind of hollow consumerism of their own moment in modern China.
Anand, tell us the significance of this movement here. Is the government concerned? Are they reacting to these young people?
I think it's actually a very healthy thing that seems disturbing on the surface. I mean, certainly Mao is not the kind of historical figure you'd want to have a beer with, and it must be said that most of these kids who like the shoes and the glasses and the skin creams of his era didn't know much about it from the history books or from firsthand experience. But I think the deeper thing that's going on here is a generation of people that has so heedlessly rushed into a very Western-looking future, some of them actually stepping back and saying, hey, what's our identity? We're this huge country that's now everybody talking about as a superpower. Who are we? What's our soul? What's our identity? And that's, I think, a healthy working out rather than their becoming a cheap copy of another country.
All right. Anand, great to see you. Very provocative article. Sorry we've run out of time here, but a very good read and very interesting what is taking place in Beijing. Thank you, Anand.